Welcome back to AI Model Optimization with Intel Neural Compressor. If you're looking to get the most optimization from quantization without having to run training, then post-training static quantization might be for you. It can seem challenging to get right, so let's start with the basics and build from there. If you remember from the second video in this series, how to choose between quantization techniques, quantizing to int8 requires an understanding of the range of values that need to be mapped to the 255 discrete integers available. This process is called calibration. Here's an overview of the entire process, but let's focus on calibration. It starts with a trained model, and it runs some inference passes with a subset of the training data to calibrate the zero points and scale factors. This calibration data set should represent the ranges that will be seen during inference. Usually about 100 samples will be enough, but it will depend on your model and data. Intel Neural Compressor uses these results to determine the scale factors, and it will then test the accuracy of the model with int8 data using an evaluation data set, comparing it to your specified accuracy metric. You have the option to define a custom evaluation function or just specify a data loader and a metric. To get started, go to the Intel Neural Compressor landing page, then the installation instructions if you need them. There's also a definition of what built-in quantization metrics Intel Neural Compressor supports across frameworks. The best way to see different approaches is to look at the suite of examples. For instance, this first one shows how simple it can be to get started with static quantization. It uses Intel Neural Compressor's built-in data loader and the built-in top K metric, and it will automatically evaluate the accuracy of a quantization pass. Alternatively, to use a custom evaluation function, let's take a look at a more realistic example. There are instructions to get this running on your own, but let's focus on the quantization code. Notice that this is similar to the simple example, but instead of specifying the eval data loader and metric, it specifies an eval function. It still uses the built-in data loader and metrics, but a custom function evaluates question answering accuracy. It processes the data loader, runs forward inference passes, then calls that custom post-processing function to calculate the error, and updates the metrics. This is a large model, so running quantization can take a couple hours, depending on your machine. The output will show that it met the accuracy goals, but had to leave two operations as FP32, and it reduced the model size by about 3x. Running the inference benchmarks on a 4th-gen Xeon scalable processor takes advantage of using int8 data on Intel Advanced Matrix Extensions, as described in part 2 of this video series. This runs a series of inference batches, so it takes a while to get through all the tests. Skipping ahead, you can see the latency reduction benefits of quantizing to int8. So if you would like to learn more about Intel Neural Compressor and static quantization, or go directly to the examples, they're both linked below or scan the QR codes. And be sure to check out the other videos in the AI Model Optimization series.